This conference will now be recorded.
Please let me know once you are able to see my screen. Hello? Kiran or someone, are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, nice. Yeah. So yes. Today we are going to learn something called PEGA. PEGA rules passes commander. Okay. We are going to learn something called PRPC. That is PEGA rules passes commander. Okay. Why we need to learn PRPC? Okay. When there are n number of languages in the market and when there are n number of tools in the market. So why we need to go for PRPC only? Okay. So it depends upon and Vishnu Vinamala. Yeah. So let's start from scratch, like when it has started and all like that, the history of the PEGA. So it started in 1983 by the person called Alan Treffler. Okay, he's the founder of the PEGA PRPC. Okay, and he started in 1983 and they went into the public issue in 1996. Okay, public issue means you know, right? So they have listed in the share market. Okay, so they listed in the either in India we can say it is a BSE, NSE. Okay, in US we can say it is like a NASDAQ, Dow Jones and all like that. Okay, but official BPM release has started from 2001 and it's used across all the domains like healthcare, communication, banking, finance, insurance and government. That means it is not limited to one particular domain. Okay, so it is used across all the domains. So what do you mean by domain? Can someone tell me? Even here I said like healthcare, communication, banking, finance, insurance, government, these all are the domains. So what do you mean by domain? Okay. Do you have an idea about the... Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, anything particular, one field is one domain.
Exactly. One sector we can say, one field we can say, like all the hospitals we can say it's like a healthcare. And all the banks we can say banking domain. Okay, so all the government offices you can say it's a government. Okay, and all the communications like Airtel, okay, Reliance, Idea, so all these things we can say it's under the communication domain. So likewise, this PEGA tool is used across all the domains. It is not limited like, okay, we can develop the application or else we can implement the application only in hospitals, or else we cannot say that it's only used in banks. So by using this tool we can implement the functionality for any domain. Okay, for any organization, we can use this PEGA tool. Okay, so likewise, and this PEGA PRPC, okay, it's used for both development and runtime environment. Okay, both development and runtime environment. Okay, what do you mean by development and what do you mean by runtime? So development is nothing but where the developer is going to implement the functionality. Okay, so for the hospital, I'm going to develop the application. So that is like a development environment. And at the same time, runtime environment. So what do you mean by runtime environment? Means where the end user is going to access the application. Okay, where the end user is going to access the application. That is like the runtime environment. And even while developing the application itself, we'll be running the application. And then we'll be seeing how exactly it will be displayed to the end user. Okay, how exactly it will be displayed to the end user. And so that means the user experience we are going to have from the development environment itself. So the user experience is nothing but the end operator who is going to be working on the application. Okay, that means if you take any of the website, okay, for the banking, okay, there are various end users. Okay, if you take ICICI Bank, there are various end users. So who are the end users for the banking website? Can someone tell me? If you have icicibank.com, so who are the end users for the icicibank.com?
Customers like who have account in that bank.
Exactly, customers. And along with the customers, only the customers can access the application or else even the employees also.
Employees also.
Nice. So employees also, right? That means sometimes I may not perform all the banking transactions from the website. Sometimes I may deposit the money by going to the branch. So at that time, who is the end user? When you give the cash to the clerk is going to be deposit account. So there, the employee of the bank is going to be the end user. But directly when you transfer the money from one account to another account in the website, the customer is going to be the end user. Okay. So likewise, whoever is going to be accessing the application, they are going to be the end users. Okay. They'll be end users. But if the end user access the application, someone has to develop that application. So who is the one developing the application means he is the one called the developer. Okay. The developer is going to develop the application. That is like a development and later runtime environment where the end user will be accessing the application. And it can be used to build business process management and business rules engine applications. Okay. So here, the PRPC can be used to build both business process management and business rules engine applications. So what do you mean by BPM and what do you mean by BRE? What do you mean by business process management, BPM, and what do you mean by business rules engine? Okay, so what exactly is the difference between these two? Okay, what exactly is the difference of these two? Okay, that we are going to learn and here. So here, if you take BPM, so it's like a process flow plus data plus business rules plus user interface. Okay, so we'll be knowing each one, one by one. So first thing, let's come to the user interface. So what is the user interface? Again, as I said, the end user who is going to be accessing the application, he will be seeing some properties, some buttons, some look and feel, and everything. The total website is called a user interface. Okay, the total website is called a user interface. So that kind of the website we can develop through Pega. And later, business rules. So what do you mean by business rule? Business rule is nothing but the conditions. Okay, so the conditions which will be applied for the application. Okay, which will be applied for the application. Again, let me take one small example. For example, I want to open the bank account. Okay, and if you want to open the bank account, can we directly open? For that, you need to have some criteria. There are some conditions are applied. Okay, so what are those conditions? So if you want to open the bank account, you need to provide the address proof. Okay, and you need to provide the PAN card. So they are the mandatory things. Okay, they are the mandatory things. So these two proofs, if you submit, then only it will allow to create the bank account. Okay, it will allow to create the bank account. And sometimes, okay, we'll be having the child account also. That is different thing. But in general, in the bank, if you want to open, the person age should be minimum 18. Okay, if the age is greater than equal to 18, then only it will allow to create the bank account. So these kind of the rules is called a business rules. These kind of the conditions, these kind of the criteria are called a business rules. So these kind of the validations we can implement through the Pega. Okay, so and along with that data. So what is the data? So data is nothing but the complete customer information. Either his, if you want to open the salary account, you should submit your payslip as well. Okay, you should submit your offer letter as well. Okay, and you should provide your office address, your company details. And along with that, you also need to provide your personal details. Okay, your present address, office address. So this complete information we can store through Pega. The data can be stored in Pega. Okay, the data can be stored in Pega. So like data, business rules, user interface. And the final one is the process flow. So what do you mean by process flow? So process flow is nothing but, so the case or else the work, what you will be performing from beginning to end is called a process flow. Okay, beginning to end is called a process flow. The complete sequence of steps which you will be performing to open the bank account, that is called a process flow. Okay, so what are the steps? As I said, if you want to open the bank account, first you need to provide the address details. So once if you provide the address details, they would be verifying. Okay, once after the verification, okay, if they are fine and the address proof which you provided and the PAN card details which you have provided are good, okay, then what they will do, they will be creating the account. And at the same time, you will be also selecting what kind of the account you wanted to create, whether it is the savings account, whether it is the current account, whether it is the salary account. Okay, so based on the type of account you wanted to create, so we will be selecting it, we will be adding one step over there. So this complete sequence of these steps, we can specify through process flow. Okay, so the flow is the fundamental and basic one to create any case. The flow is the fundamental thing. Why? Because first it is going to start the case, and in that collect the customer details, and then validate the customer details, and then create the type of account, and then end the case. So from then onwards, creation of the account is done. Later he can do the transactions accordingly. So while creating this flow, in this flow only, as I said, initially we will be collecting the customer details. So once after collecting the customer details, that information you will be saving into the database. So this collecting the customer details, that entire information like, okay, Ashok, and again number, and again address. So all these things, it's like a data. So that data, how we are collecting? From the user interface. Okay, and after collecting the data, what we'll be doing, we'll be verifying whether the certain conditions are met or not. His age, his address verification, his PAN number validation. So all these things we can apply through the business rule. So together, all these four is called a BPM, business process management. Okay, business process management. So next, coming to the BRE. Okay, so what is BRE? Business rules engine. So in the BPM, I said process flow plus data plus business rules. So here the third one I said is the business rules. So as I said, when you create business rule, when you apply any condition, that information will be saved again. So that information will be saved into the database. So age validation we need to perform. Address validation we need to perform. PAN card validation we need to perform. Okay, so this entire validations is called a, can be performed by the BRE. Okay, business rules engine will be performing all the types of the validations. So external application calls into the rules engine to execute a specific rule, set of rules. And here there is no user interface through PRPC for the user running the applications. Okay, so only business rules also you can develop in Pega, and that can be given to the external applications for performing the validations. In the BPM, what I said, process flow, data, business rules plus user interface. And in the BRE, only business rules can be implemented, and that can be given to the external applications. That means, for example, for the ICICI Bank, I have a .NET application. Otherwise, I have a Java application. But in that, for implement the validations, you can use either .NET, Java, otherwise you can also use Pega for creating the validations, and that validations can be applied in Java or .NET applications as well. Are you getting or any doubt? Kiran, Ashok, Subha, Ram?
Yeah, getting.
Okay, fine, right? So very simple here. In the BPM, what I said, the complete application can be created in Pega itself, like the user interface, flow, data, and again business rules. Okay, in the BPM I said everything can be created in Pega itself. But if the application is already existing in the .NET, okay, so if you want to implement only the business rules, even those business rules you can create in Pega, and that can be referred or accessed from the external application that is like a .NET or Pega, .NET or Java. Okay, so this kind of the reusability is possible from Pega. So in Pega, you can create one condition and that can be accessed from multiple applications. Here, the business rule means I just said a small scenario. Okay, I told very small scenario. What is that? Just age validation. But sometimes there will be bigger validations can be applied. Okay, so what could be that bigger validations? Sometimes in the bank account itself, okay, for the savings account, the minimum balance should be 10,000. Okay, the minimum balance should be 10,000. Okay, so that is also one kind of the business condition, business validation. Okay, likewise, n number of the business validations conditions you can apply. So, and that can be referred from Pega to any other application. So for doing this business validation, it is not required to have any user interface. So this is just a validation. And that validation can be referred from any user interface application. Okay, either that user interface application would be in Pega itself, otherwise .NET or Java, otherwise SAP or any other. So no user interface through PRPC for the user running the applications. Okay, for the user running the applications. That is like a BPM and BRE, business process management and business rules engine. So business rules engine maintains only the business rules. Okay, only the business rules. So this Pega is a combination of both of them. Okay, in the market, there are n number of the BPM tools available. Okay, there are n number of the BPM tools in the market available. Lombardi, Oracle BPM, Savian, Appian, JBPM, TIP, O-Informatica. Okay, but Pega is very popular than all other BPM tools. Okay, Pega is the most popular one. Okay, almost all the big organizations are using Pega, and even the Pega software is very costly. And even as we know, in general also, we need to upgrade our skills as and when the technology changes. Okay, so we need to be up to date in the market to survive in the industry. In the same way, Pega also, okay, in the same way, Pega also, okay, what it is doing? Upgrading their versions continuously. Okay, Pega also upgrading their versions continuously. The very initial version is 3.4. The very initial version is the 3.4. So, and later they released 4.1, 4.2, and later 5.1, 5.1.6, 5.2, 5.3, 5.4, 6.1, 6.2, 3, 4, 7.1, 7.2, 7.3, 7.4, and later 8, 8.1, 8.2. So the current version is the 8.2. So as they are going to adding n number of features and they are releasing the new versions in the market, that is the reason why Pega is more popular across the world, across the IT industry. Okay, whenever any new technology comes, they are going to integrating with them. Okay, they are going to integrating with them. Okay, so I said versions 3.4 to currently 8.2. So what do you mean by this version? Can anybody have the idea what do you mean by version? If you take Java also, initially it was different and now it is different, even .NET also. Okay, 2.0, 2.1. Okay, what is the difference of these versions? Means, so when they release any product, when they released the product, it was 3.4. And later they have added few more features. Okay, and then they are going to release the new version. So for each and every release, they are going to specify one version. Even if you take Android OS also, it is having different versions. I hope everybody knows that. And even if you take Windows also, okay, there are n number of the versions. Okay, that means they are going to be adding the new features and releasing the new version. Okay, with the new features, they are releasing the new version. Okay, and here when they are releasing the versions, as I said, okay, high level I mentioned that 5.1, 6.1, 7.1, 8.2 like that, but it's having more number of the versions like 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.4 and 6.1, 6.2. So why sometimes they are increasing the second number, second digit, and why they are releasing the first digit sometimes? when they will be increasing 5.1 to 5.2, 5.2 to 5.3, and when they will be giving directly from 5.4 to 6.1. What could be the reason that they are not giving simply 5.4 to 5.5? Why they moved from 5.4 to 6.1? Can someone tell me what could be the reason of two digits? The main purpose of the two digits indicates if there is very minor features are added, then they are going to increase the minor version. Okay, minor version is the 5.1, 1 is the minor version and 5 is the major version. Okay, major and minor. Okay, major and minor. So minor means there are not much changes in the features. But whereas if it is the major means there is a big difference in the features. In Pega features, there is a lot of changes. So in that case, they will be giving the major versions. They will be changing the major version. So likewise, they are going to releasing the new versions with new features. Okay, so based on the client requirement. So that is the reason why Pega is more popular. Not only that, and comparatively with all other applications, like if you take Java or .NET, the development time which it takes is 50% lesser in Pega. That means to implement one application in .NET or Java, if it takes 1 year, the same application you can develop in Pega in just 6 months. So that means 6 months time is going to be saved for you. Okay, so the client is getting his application very faster. Okay, so those are the versions likewise, and along with that, the performance of the application as well. So not only the development time, even the performance of the application also very good. So that means when you open any website which is developed in .NET may take 1 minute, but the same thing will take in 15 to 20 seconds to open the application which is developed in Pega. So the performance also very good. And even at the same time, security. So what is the security? We created one bank application. So if someone hacks my account, what will happen? They are going to transfer our amount to other person's account. Okay, but the application which is developed in other languages, okay, is less security comparatively with Pega. Pega is more powerful security features it has, so by which it is going to be stop the hacking of the application. Okay, and even the maintenance cost. So as I said, to implement an application, it's taking 1 year, but in Pega, 6 months. So obviously the maintenance cost also will be reduced. So the development time reduced. So obviously the salaries of the employees, developers, okay, so the customer maintenance, everything is going to be reduced accordingly. And even the database setup also is very easy. Okay, database setup also, it's very easy from Pega. So what is the database? Can someone tell me what is the database?
It's like a storage, store the data.
Exactly. It's like a storage. Okay. So where exactly you will be saving the customer details or else the account details or else the employee details. So everything we will be saving in one particular central location. Okay. That is like a database. So there are n number of the RDBMSs, database packages is there. So can we know what are those databases available in the market? Like Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, okay, from IBM DB2 is there, and MySQL is there, and PostgreSQL is there. Likewise, n number of the databases are there. Okay, relational database management systems, RDBMS packages are there. Okay, so the connecting from Pega application to RDBMS packages is also very easy. We can easily connect to them. Okay, the database setup also, we can do it very faster. And the web service. So what is the purpose of the web service? Web service is nothing but to access the future from one application to another application, we will be using the web service. I just shared some time back, like I implement the business rule in Pega, and that can be accessed from where? .NET application, or else Java application, or else SAP. Okay, so like that, accessing the information or else accessing the business rules from one application to another application, we can do through web services. Getting right? Anybody has any doubt, please stop me immediately and you can ask me. Okay. Silence, I feel as a...
It's fine, sir, no doubt.
Okay, great. Thank you. So, web service means mainly to cross communication of the applications. Okay, it is not only from Pega to Java or else Pega to .NET. Even there may be some future available in Java or else there may be some future available in .NET. So that future, if you want to access from Pega, then also you can use it through web services. And even as I said, the data may be available in SQL Server. Okay, from SQL Server to Pega, if you want to access these customer details, through web service, you can access it. Okay, web service is one of the way to access the information, and there may be n number of the ways to access the information. Okay, but Pega supports these web services also. Okay, sometimes the weather information, okay, the weather forecast, if you want to see in your website, if you want to display in your website. So somebody has already taken the weather information. So that information, if you want to display in your website, then through web service, you can access it. So we will be learning all these things, how exactly we can save the data to the database, how to read the data from the database, and how to access the web services, how to create a web service in Pega and give it to the external applications, and how the external application web service can be accessed to the Pega. So these things, everything we are going to learn in the later sessions. Okay, as I said, there are n number of the domains available, okay, and the Pega can be accessed in any domain. Okay, here I specified few of them, and it is not limited to only these things. It can be accessed from the any domain. Okay, healthcare, banking, insurance, communication, marketing, manufacturing, government, loans, and all these things. Can someone tell me in the marketing domain, what exactly comes? Do we have any marketing website? Online shop. Flipkart, Amazon. Okay, so all these things are Snapdeal. All these things are the marketing domains. So marketing website. Even we can implement the websites like Amazon.com from Pega also. Okay, and we have something called various frameworks also in Pega. So what do you mean by framework? So before knowing about the CPM SISD, if you know what you mean by framework, then we can discuss about the existing frameworks. So framework is nothing but some reusable futures, so which we can use it in my application. Okay, so for example, I have implemented an application for ICICI Bank for creating the customer account, okay, and later for performing the transactions. Okay, and later I got an order from HDFC Bank as well to implement the application for the HDFC Bank. So in that case, we may have to implement the functionality again for HDFC Bank. For ICICI Bank, I implemented a website for 6 months. And later, if HDFC Bank comes, what I need to do? again, I need to start from the scratch. And later, it may take 6 months for them as well. So it's like a waste of the time. So what I can do here, I can implement one banking application which can be suitable for all the banks. So today, if ICICI Bank comes and wants to create the application for them, what I can do is I can simply change the name of the organization, and if there are any business rules difference, I can update them and I can give it to them. Okay, that means I'm going to modifying the business scenarios for that particular bank and by changing few of them. Means in the ICICI Bank, for the savings account, the minimum balance is 10,000. But whereas in the HDFC Bank savings account, the minimum balance is 20,000. So instead of implementing the complete business rule again, what I can do is I can simply create a reusable business rule, and there I can change the value from 10,000 to 20,000, and I can change the company name from ICICI Bank to HDFC Bank, and I can give it to the HDFC Bank. So initially for the ICICI Bank it took 6 months, and later for the HDFC Bank I delivered the application in just 1 month. Okay, in just 1 month. So that kind of the reusable futures is called frameworks. Okay, that kind of the reusable futures is called framework. So there are n number of the futures, there are n number of these frameworks. So what are they? Okay, CPM. Okay, and in the same way SI, SD. Okay, so CPM, customer process management. Like any customer service interactions, we can use the CPM framework. And smart investigate. SI means smart investigate. SD means smart dispute. Okay, smart dispute. That means in the banks, if there are any disputes happen, okay, for resolving the disputes, we can use the smart dispute. And smart investigate also for banking application only. Okay, if any dispute comes, first how we will be investigating that dispute. And later after investigating, how we will resolve the dispute, that is the SD. So likewise, Pega has created some default frameworks, and we can reuse these frameworks and we can implement the functionality accordingly. And in case if you have the application for any insurance company, like okay, Bharti AXA or else ICICI Lombard, likewise even we have n number of the insurance organization. So if you want to develop the application for any of the insurance organization, we can reuse the Pega insurance framework and develop the application. You can directly implement the application on Pega, okay, but even you can reuse the application insurance which is developed by Pega framework. So again, in one word, if you want to say, to develop the .NET application in Pega, it will take 6 months. But if you reuse the framework which is having in Pega, like insurance framework, even it is going to reduce the time from 6 months to 4 months. Okay, so the same application in .NET or Java takes 1 year, but if you use the Pega and with insurance framework, you would be able to deliver it within 4 months itself. And PMF, Pega Marketing Framework. So the Pega Marketing Framework is nothing but, again, if you want to develop any application for marketing like Amazon, then you can reuse this PMF. And if you want to use it for any hospitals kind of the things, we can use the healthcare application also. So likewise, there are n number of the frameworks available in Pega. So based on the client, we can reuse the frameworks, and again, we can implement the functionality accordingly. Got it right? Clear about the framework? Framework means there is a predefined application already developed by Pega, and based on the client, we can use that framework, and again, we can implement the functionality. Okay, this predefined futures we can use to implement the functionality of the end client. Okay. Next, the architecture. So what is the PEGA architecture? How exactly it is going to work? Okay, so the base software in any of the computer we'll be having is the operating system, OS. That can be either Windows, Linux, or Unix, or JBoss, or something else like that. Okay, so on top of the operating system, we'll be having the database. That can be, as I said, Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, or DB2. And on top of that, we'll be having development kit, Java JDK. Okay, and on top of that, we'll be having the app server. Okay, there are n number of the app servers again available in the market. Okay, that can be either WebSphere, WebLogic, JBoss, or Apache Tomcat. Okay, on top of this app server, the PEGA application will be installed. Okay, on top of that, we'll be installing the PEGA application. And in the PEGA, we'll be using the PEGA frameworks, and again, we'll be developing the applications accordingly. Okay, this is the architecture of the total our computer. Okay. We can have any OS, we can have any database, we can have any JDK, okay, any app server kind of the things like that. Okay, so if you take like this in the graphical way, for example, I have Windows 2000, okay, and with Sun Solaris, otherwise, okay, IBM P series. Okay, so here I have installed the PEGA rules process commander, okay, which is available on Tomcat or WebSphere or WebLogic. Okay, this is the application server. In the application server, we will be having the PEGA. So this is going to connect to the RDBMS. Okay, either can be SQL, Oracle, DB2. Okay, and in this RDBMS, it is going to have the rule base. So what is the rule base? The rule base is nothing but our PEGA created rules will be stored in this rule base. Okay, rule base is nothing but a database in the RDBMS server. Okay, so this PEGA application can be accessed from the Internet Explorer, that is the workstation. And here it's not only the Internet Explorer, any browser. It can be either Chrome or else anything else. Okay, so this is the overall architecture in the graphical way. So in general, from our laptop or else from our desktop, through IE, we will be accessing. So how it is going to connect? It is going to connect to the PRPC, which is running on the application server, which is already connected to the RDBMS server. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, nice. So here we will be having various certifications. And before going to the certifications, here we have something called 6Rs. In PEGA, if you want to implement any application, so it is basically on top of 6Rs. So many process commander applications provide business process management and automation through 6 fundamental capabilities. They are informally known as the 6Rs. So what are those 6Rs? That is like receiving, routing, reporting, researching, responding, and resolving. Okay. If you develop any application, that will be part of this 6Rs. As I said, if you want to develop any application, for example, I want to apply for the vehicle insurance. Okay, if you want to apply the vehicle insurance, what you will be doing? You will be applying for the insurance. So when you apply for the insurance, the company is going to receiving your personal details. Okay, accepting and capturing the essential detail, essential data, describing work from multiple sources in multiple media and formats, from keyboards, scanners, and external systems. Okay, the company is going to receive your personal information. So sometimes I'll be calling to the customer agent and I'll be asking to have the vehicle insurance. Otherwise, sometimes through online itself, I can apply for the vehicle insurance. Okay, sometimes I'm going to that particular office and applying for the insurance. So likewise, there are various ways you are going to requesting for the insurance. So when you request, the company is going to receive that information. Okay, and once they receive the information, they will be routing to the particular department. Okay, they will be routing to the particular department. So what exactly that? What exactly is meant by routing? Vehicle insurance is one way. And for example, I am applying for the home loan. Okay, if you apply for the home loan, what you will do? You will be providing all the necessary information. like your address proof, your payslip, your income details, okay, your company details, your PAN card information. Then immediately they will be routing to various departments, like house address verification, one department will be there. Office address verification, one more department will be there. Okay, and your company details like payslip and PAN card and bank statement information, one more department will be there. So they'll be routing your details to various departments, and then they will be doing the verification. Okay, once after they do the verification, if they are fine with the home address and if they are fine with your office address and your company details, okay, then they'll be again sending back to the main person. They'll be rerouting to the actual person. Okay, that actual person, what he will do, he will be take the report. Okay, so is the address verification is good or not? Is the home address is good or not? Okay, is it valid or not? So likewise, he will be taking the report. Okay, so how he will be taking the report? By doing some kind of the research. Okay, from here, he will be taking all this information from the database. So the reporting will be generated from the database that can be done through searching or researching. Okay, and if everything is fine, he is going to responding to the customer saying that, okay, your application is valid. Okay, otherwise he would be replying saying that, okay, we need more clarification on your house address. Okay, in case still, if it is not valid, he would be rejecting your home loan application. So that rejecting the application or else by accepting the application can be done through resolving that. Okay, through resolving that. So likewise, any case, anything can be part of these six R's. Okay, and here it can be have all the six phases, otherwise it may be having few phases based on the need. But in general, mostly all these six phases will be applied for any case, for any operation, for any implementation. Okay, so the same thing here we applied through graphical. So here receiving, so they are going to receive through online, that is browser, or else through web service, otherwise from the directly, or else from the scanners, fax. Okay, and then they are going to route it. So skill based routing through priority and cases and folders. Okay, for verification they will be routing it. So and then they will be taking some kind of the report from the databases and product and quality, and then they are going to research it. Okay, so from the database itself, they are going to check whether they are valid or not. And then they are going to respond to the customer either through email, otherwise through the personal follow-ups, or else through the fax. Okay, so what they will be responding by saying it is rejected or else it is accepted. So these are the six R's will be applied for the complete functionality which we implement in Pega. And so as I said, we will be having various certifications. So at the basic level, we will be having the CSA certification, Certified System Architect, and little advanced is Certified Senior System Architect. Okay, initially if you have 1-2 years of experience, we can say I'm a CSA certified. So this is the add-on advantage, and every organization will be asking what are the certifications you have done. Okay, so generally we can do CSA or CSSA. And the third one is the CLSA, Certified Lead System Architect. Okay, these certifications we can do from any Pega centers. Okay, Pega certification centers will be there. Okay, by going to that certifications, you can do. By taking my classes, you can easily write CSA and again CSSA certification. These two certifications you can easily clear that. And CLSA is the most advanced certification, and it is not just an online exam. So they are going to give one small application to you, and you have to implement that application within 1 week, and you have to give the application to the Pega systems. So they are going to verify your application and say whether they are good or not. So if they are good, then they are going to provide the CLSA certification. So if you do CLSA certification, your package will be minimum of 30 lakhs per annum. So that is very good certification advantage, and you will be having the complete knowledge about the application, you can easily develop it once you do CLSA. And sometimes the business analyst also will be doing the certification. So that is called a certified Pega business architect. Okay, so they are not the developers. They are just the business architects. And we will be also having user interface specialist. So even he is also not a developer, but he will be having the Pega knowledge and he will be only developing the user interface forms. But in general, CSA, CSSA itself, we will be developing the user interfaces as well. But sometimes few people wants to be specialized only on the user interface part, then they'll be doing this, so this course, this certification. So likewise, but for you people, if you want to settle down as a developer, then you can go for the CSSA and the CSA. So the first we need to write CSA and later we need to write CSSA. That's it. Okay, and as I said, we'll be having the various versions, and here the current 8.2 released, and still it is not in the market. Still it is not available in the market. So in the Pega website, you can see that 8.2 is available. They are going to release it. And we are going to learn on 7.4. Okay, we are going to learn 7.4. Right now, most of the companies are using 7.1.6, 7.1.7, and 7.1.8. Very few organizations are using 7.4. Okay, and if you learn 7.4, you can easily work on 7.1 also. Okay, you are good to implement the functionality on 7.1 as well. Okay, so that's all, guys. So this is all about the induction. Okay, so from tomorrow, we'll be starting the implementation from Pega application. So you are good, or do you have any queries? You can ask me. Somebody wants to speak something. I could hear some sounds, but I could not hear the voice. Okay, great. Okay, then. See you. Hello?
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Yeah, Pega Mashup is nothing but, as I said, we will be accessing the application from one technology to another technology. Okay, so from .NET, Pega, you can access the information. Okay, from Pega to you can access the .NET application. Sometimes what happens, you know, my complete application is already in .NET and I am starting the same application from Pega also. Okay, I want to re-implement the same functionality in Pega also. Okay, so .NET lo pedda application di ICICI bank di application ni nen Pega lo kuda implement cheyali. Implement cheyadaniki it may take around 6 months. So until then I need to use the .NET application. So ee 6 months aithe .NET minne work cheyali nenu. Kani website emo Pega lo create chesanu. Okay, are you understanding? I have implemented the Pega website at the high level. Okay, but few of the forms, few of the user interfaces are available in .NET application, which I have not yet implemented in Pega. So in that case, what I can do is only that particular form which I implemented in .NET, I want to access in Pega also. Okay, let me create one thing. This is Pega application. This is .NET application. Okay, in Pega, in the browser, when you open, okay, in the browser, if you open icicibank.com, okay, after login, okay, you will be seeing
after login, you'll be seeing various options. Okay, so what are those options? Update personal info. Funds transfer. Update KYC. Pay utility bills. Okay, so likewise, I have four options. When I select each and every option, each and every link, the respective user interface will be displayed. Santosh, are you understanding?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so when I select update personal info, that form will be displayed. When I select fund transfer, that form will be displayed. Okay, update KYC, that particular form will be displayed to accept the KYC details. If you select this option, this will be displayed. But as I started this Pega application just 1 month back, I only have the user interface for update personal info, funds transfer. But update KYC, pay utility bills, features are not implemented in Pega application. But if you take these things, all these features are already available in .NET. Okay, all these features are already available in .NET. Update KYC, pay utility bills. So here what I want to do, until unless I implement update KYC, pay utility bills. Okay, so when I select update KYC, as I don't have the form in Pega, I will be loading this update KYC user interface. Okay, this update KYC user interface I'll be taking from Pega. PAN number. Name. Okay, and some other fields. So this is the update KYC form. Okay, so as I said, I don't have this update KYC feature in Pega. What I'll be doing is, on click of the update KYC link, okay, I will be calling this update KYC form from .NET to Pega, and here I'll be displaying here. Okay, here on click of the update KYC, I'll be loading the form which was implemented from .NET to Pega. Once after implementation of the update KYC in Pega, I will be removing the connection from Pega to .NET, and then I will be displaying the form which I implemented in Pega itself. Okay, that is called mashup. Mashup means accessing the application, external application feature from Pega, the complete user interface and features. Okay, this mashup is also called IAC. Okay, Internet Application Composer. Okay, Internet Application Composer. Okay, that is called a mashup. Accessing the application from one application to another application. Clear, Santosh, or any doubts?
Yeah, clear. In this scenario, we can use also. Okay, here we are integration mode use case, correct?
Sorry, Santosh.
Integration.
Yeah, integration here. You are asking integration as a separate scenario or here?
Here.
Here we don't.
Integration mode use case. Okay.
Here, nowhere related to integration. IAC. Okay. Mashup is just one completely different feature in Pega.
Okay.
So by using this feature, it can access. And one more thing, it is not mean that only from .NET application you can access in Pega. It can be Java application also, or else it can be SAP also. And that even this can be Pega also. Okay, what do you mean by in Pega itself? As I said here, it is for this functionality is available in the HDFC Pega application. Okay, now I am implementing the feature for ICICI Bank. This is also Pega application only. This is also Pega application only. But this is different application. This is different application. And as this feature is not available here, if you want to access from HDFC also, you can access it. So IAC, this Internet Application Composer, is mainly for accessing the future from different application to current application. And the different application might be developed in any technology, including Pega. Still, you can access it. Okay?
Listeners
also, I'm coming. So the listeners feature is mainly used for various purposes. Like there are file listener, MQ listener, and Java listener, and email listener. Okay, likewise, these are the four listeners available in Pega. Okay, so in this, mostly we will be using email listener, and the other one is file listener. So what is the purpose of this file listener? So listener means it is going to execute automatically. The very first thing is listener means it is going to execute automatically. We will not be performing anything. So when it is going to execute means, for example, I have a Excel file. In the Excel file, I have a customer details. Okay, customer ID, customer name, address, city, state. Likewise, I have 10 customer details. Okay, customer ID 1, okay, Santosh, okay, Hyderabad. Customer ID 2, Ashok, Hyderabad. Customer ID 3, Ram from Karimnagar or something. So I have likewise 10 customer records I have. For all these customer details, I want to create an account. Okay, so what I will do, this Excel file, I will be placing in one central location, one folder. So whenever I place a folder, whenever I place a Excel file in the folder, so this file listener is going to read the Excel file, and it is going to read each and every record, and it is going to create a customer details in Pega application. Understanding, right? So file listener is mainly for reading the external file. That can be Excel file, or else that can be text file, or else that can be CSV file, comma separated file it is called. Okay, and then based on the information in the file, we are going to perform some action in Pega. So one example I said is creating the account for the customer. Or else sometimes I want to read this Excel file and I want to save all these customer details from Excel file to the SQL Server database. Even in the SQL Server, I have customer details table. Okay, to the table, if you want to copy, you can do it through file listener. So file listener is completely for reading the file. So that file can be Excel, text file, otherwise CSV file. Getting right?
Okay.
The last one is the email listener. So what is the purpose of the email listener? Means if you want to send out a mail to someone, then this email listener works. Okay, so as I said, for creating the home loan application, okay, and after complete processing, I want to intimate the customer saying your file is approved or else your file is rejected. So that email, if you want to send, you can send it to the customers through the email listener. And sometimes even after doing the address verification, I may need more information. In that case also, you can send out an email through the email listener. or else sometimes I have a supermarket and I'm maintaining the soaps, like I'm having the quantity of the each and every item, like Colgate toothpaste. So whenever the quantity breaches one particular level, so always I want to maintain 30 in my stock. The Colgate toothpaste should be the minimum quantity 30. So as in when I sell it, when the quantity goes less than 30, I want to send out a mail to the shop owner saying Colgate toothpaste breaches less than 30 minimum quantity. So send out a mail to the owner, then the owner is going to put the order for the Colgate toothpaste. Likewise, for any of the intimation, we will be using the email list now. And MQN Java, it is not mandatory. Okay, you can say that I don't have much idea, in case if your interviewer asks that. Okay, MQN Java listener. So mainly file listener and email listener, the people will be asking. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So still yeah, anybody have any doubts?
Yeah.
Yes, means you have the doubts or no? Okay. Yeah, if no doubts, then see you tomorrow. And I request everyone to join at sharp 8 a.m. Okay, so that we can close at sharp 9 a.m. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. See you guys. Have a good day.
Yeah.